waiting until things get really bad to make a change. I know you know what I'm talking about. It's when you've outgrown a situation and you know it deep down, but you stick it out anyway because it's familiar. And then the suffering slowly grows, but you tolerate it. And then the red flags get bigger, but you justify it. And then your body feels tense and heavy and you feel like you're suffocating, but you bulldoze your way through it. And then at one point, the pain becomes too much to bear. And it's that moment that you feel like you just can't take one more day at this job or one more day in this relationship or one more day in this living situation, or else you're going to explode. And then you finally do something about it. You become so desperate that you're willing to do whatever it takes to escape the pain you feel. And then when you finally do pull the trigger, you look back and think, damn, I should have done that a lot sooner. We've all been there, you guys. But one of the many lessons I've learned in my own personal development journey is that it doesn't have to get to that point. Our brains are motivated by pain or pleasure. But more times than not, the pain train wins because humans will do much more to avoid pain than they will to gain pleasure. Like imagine two boats, okay? Holly is in one rowboat and Mary is in the other rowboat. And then out at sea in their line of vision is a yacht. Both ladies think time and time again, wouldn't that be nice to upgrade my rowboat one day? And then after some time, the functionality of Holly's boat slowly starts to decline, but she hangs on. And then her boat begins to decline some more, and then some more, and then some more. While Mary's boat is in average condition, it's not a yacht, but it keeps her afloat and isn't deteriorating like Holly's is. Now, who do you think is going to be more motivated to make a change and level up to a newer boat? Holly. Because humans will do much more to avoid pain than they will to gain pleasure. I don't know if that was a good example, but that's what I got. But it's important to know that you have the option, you guys. We have the willpower to evoke change even if we're not completely miserable. For example, my last nannying job, I loved the family I was with. I truly enjoyed working with them. There was nothing necessarily wrong with my job. But I knew that if I wanted to level up and make more money and have more freedom, I had to step fully into the role of coach, which meant I had to make the decision to leave that job. And it was a very different experience for me because I used to let circumstances get so incredibly awful until I had no other choice but to change it. Like when I'd have an explosive argument, you know, with a roommate or curse my boss out on the way out the door. I didn't really curse them out, but you know what I mean. But I didn't want it to get to that point for me or for them. So anyway, that's an example of being motivated by pleasure. It requires a heightened sense of self-awareness, courage, and a deep desire to better yourself. So what I want to offer you today is to just notice where maybe you're sticking it out from comfort, not growth. Just observe and assess. If something is really working and you're just enjoying the fruits of your last evolvement, like you don't have to fix it, obviously, right? However, if something is working, but you know deep down you're cutting yourself short, that's something to look at. And you'll know by how it feels in your body. If you feel light and free and expansive, keep it. But if you feel heavy, restricted, and limited, reevaluate. Guys, changing for more pleasure requires massive truth-telling with yourself. It's not easy. But if your antennas are going up right now, a great question to ask yourself is this. Okay, what is it costing me not to seek and initiate change in this area of my life? No decisions need to be made, just calm your brain down, but the simple awareness and truth telling will get the wheels turning. the very first phase of coaching that I guide each and every one of my clients through is the change cycle. Change hurts, whether it's from pain or pleasure. But when it's from pain, you feel hostile and resentful. When it's from pleasure, it feels clean and necessary. Either way, I help you navigate change as quickly as possible so that you can level up as quickly as possible. So if you're interested in getting coached, the information is down below. Thank you guys so much for watching. Have an amazing week, and I will see you next Wednesday.